responses by the end of the day, so
this
that I can compile your marks and I can submit. Those who do not submit their answers by the end of the day will be given zero. Their answers will not be considered after 5 p.m. today. Okay, so let me proceed. In the previous few classes, I have been discussing about noise in AM receivers, noise in FM receivers, as well as noise in double sideband suppressed carrier receivers. When we consider the impact of noise in a communication system, we generally compute three parameters in this communication system. You know that a simple block diagram of communication consists of a transmitter, a communication channel, and a receiver. And here in the communication channel, the noises gets added up. We have discussed various types of noise, namely Johnson noise. And for constructing a framework for analyzing the noise, we have assumed that the noise that gets added up in the communication channel is additive white Gaussian noise in nature, so that we can develop a framework for the analysis of other types of noises that we may encounter in the communication channel. So we have considered additive white Gaussian noise, right? And here at the transmitter, this is the signal to noise ratio at the input. So I'll call this as SNRI. And this is the ratio of average transmitted power divided by average noise power, right? And this signal is sent wirelessly or through wired medium over long distance, and it reaches the input of the receiver. At the input of the receiver, I will be computing this signal to noise ratio termed as SNRC. Now this SNRC is the ratio of received signal power, ratio of average received signal power divided by the average noise power. Now this signal will be passed through various blocks inside this receiver, and at the output of the receiver, I'll be computing another SNR named as SNRO. This is the ratio of the average output power divided by the average noise power. And if we look at the weightage allocated to each of these signal to noise ratios, the signal to noise ratio at the input should be the highest, followed by the signal to noise ratio at the output of the receiver, and then the signal to noise ratio at the carrier, at the input of the receiver, termed as channel signal to noise ratio. This is how the weightage of signal to noise ratios should be present, so that we can have reliable communication. If there is mismatch in the weightage obtained for SNRO and SNRC, then our system, receiver system, becomes unreliable. The receiver system may or may not be able to efficiently demodulate or decode the transmitted signal, right? So that is the reason why we compute SNRC and SNRO, and then we consider these two signal to noise ratios to compute the figure of merit. Figure of merit is the ratio of SNRO divided by SNRC. Okay, so we have computed figure of merit FM, FOM, and we have computed figure of merit for AM receivers, DSPAC receivers, as well as FM receivers. Now today we shall discuss two concepts related to FM receivers, and then we will solve some numerical problems. Okay, and in between I may take attendance, so please be attentive and listen carefully. If you have any doubts, you can unmute yourself and ask me or comment in the chat box. Right, so moving on to the capture effect in the FM receivers. Whenever I transmit a signal from the transmitter, listen carefully, this is the transmitter, and if I'm transmitting the signal from the transmitter, this signal has to travel through a complex communication channel. This is a complex communication channel. Now in the communication channel, we may have buildings, we may have trees, we may have many types of obstacles, and these signals may fall on these buildings or these trees, and they may experience some sort of reflection, some sort of refraction before it reaches the receiver. So even though you have transmitted one single signal from the transmitter, because of the complex nature of the communication channel, by the time the signal reaches the receiver, you may have two or three variants of these signals. This signal may be arriving at the input of the receiver. Thus, this receiver should be smart enough. This receiver should be smart enough to accept these inputs and identify which is the valid input and pass only that valid input for further signal processing and attenuate all the unwanted signals. To give you a small insight into this, assume that I have said how are you, right? So this is the signal that I have sent. Because of the complex communication channel, the first signal I'll hear it as how you, then second signal I may receive it as how are, and third signal I may receive as how are you. So first signal is how are, second signal is how you, third signal is how are you. So what I'll do is I'll compare all the three signals amplitude levels as well as its frequency with respect to the center frequency, and then I will take judgment regarding which signal to pass for further signal processing. So that processing by comparing multiple inputs received and accepting only the valid one for further signal processing is considered as capture effect in FM receivers, right? So I'll repeat this again. The transmitted signal is a single signal. When it is propagating in a complex communication channel, the signal will fall on buildings and trees and many other obstacles, and that will experience reflection and refractions, and at the receiver you may receive multiple variants of the same signal. So your receiver should be smart enough to identify which are the unwanted signals, which are the signals that should be discarded, and which signal should be processed further so that we can demodulate the signal. So this process of validating a right signal for further signal processing is considered as capture effect. Okay, so you can see in this diagram, I have three signals. Signal A, signal B, and signal C. Look at signal A. Signal A has highest power, followed by signal B, and then signal C. And signal A is also nearer to the center frequency, whereas signal B is has moved slightly to the right hand side, and its received signal is 2 dB less than the maximum signal power. And if you look at signal C, this has 3 dB less signal power compared to maximum signal power, that is signal A, and it has moved or deviated to the left hand side. So if this is the scenario, I'll compare these three and then I will select appropriate signal. So can someone tell me which is the appropriate signal that I should be selecting here? We have signal A, signal B, signal C. Can you tell me which signal is the right signal, which is the appropriate signal that I should be considering? Which is the right signal that I should be considering? Please comment in the chat box. Signal A has highest power and it is located. Signal B has 2 dB less power and it has moved to the right hand side. Signal C has 3 dB less power and it has moved to the right hand side. So out of these three signals, which signal do you think is the appropriate one? Please comment in the chat box. Am I audible? Can someone say yes or no? Which signal should I consider for further processing? Am I audible? Can someone say yes or no? Thank you. Okay, yeah. So good. So Lavanya, Neha, Mukta. Mohammed has responded yes. So we have to consider signal A because this has highest power and it is located almost closer to the center frequency, right? So capture effect in FM. FM receiver looks at the stronger of the two received signals of same frequency and suppresses the weaker one. So this capture ratio is the necessary difference between the two signals before we take some action. Typically there should be a difference of 1 dB, right? So you can see that between signal A and signal B there is a difference of 2 dB, and between signal A and signal C there is a difference of 3 dB. So we can go ahead and select signal A, right? So capture effect is defined as the suppression of weaker signal at the receiver but attenuated. Okay, so this is the inherent ability of FM, which helps us in minimizing the unwanted signals or noise components in FM. Okay, so that's about capture effect. And if you have two signals with almost same signal strength and almost same frequencies or almost same frequency deviation, the receiver constantly compares both the signals and it fluctuates back and forth between them. Okay, so if some signal is at say 1 dB and another signal is at say almost 0.8 dB, almost at same frequency deviation, so and if there is fluctuation, if this is becoming 1.2 and 0.8 and this is becoming 1.3 and 0.8, so the receiver will fluctuate between these two signals. Okay, so that's the phenomenon of capture effect. Moving on to FM threshold effect, this is associated with the carrier signal to noise ratio. I've already told you that we have three signal to noise ratios, namely SNR I, that is at the transmitter, then you have SNR C, that is at the input of the, this is at the input of the receiver, and then you have SNR O, which is computed at the output of the receiver. Now if the, I have already told you that highest SNR should be this, that is SNR I, second should be SNR O, third should be SNR C. Now, if the SNR C is greater than SNR O, then the amount of noise present will be more than the amount of signal power present, and that leads to enormous amount of distortion, and that scenario should be avoided. Hence, we have FM threshold effect, wherein we try to ensure that the carrier to carrier noise ratio or SNRC is maintained at least greater than or equal to 1, so that FM receiver can demodulate the transmitted signal efficiently. If the SNRC value becomes greater than SNRO, then the receiver is unable to recover back the message signal, and its performance degrades significantly, right? And when the SNRC value increases, that leads to various types of noises, namely cracking or spotting noise, which are nothing but noises present at the receiver. So to avoid this, we ensure that SNR is at least greater than or equal to 1, and the value of SNRC is less than SNRO, right? So that phenomenon of maintaining SNRC above certain threshold is referred to as threshold effect. Okay, so if this threshold effect or this threshold limit is violated, the FM receiver will not be able to reliably demodulate the transmitted signal and our message signal, right? So this is the equation that we have computed for the figure of merit at the output of the FM receiver. If FM threshold is violated, the carrier signal to noise ratio decreases below certain point. Below this point, the signal to noise ratio also decreases significantly, and that leads to degradation of the FM receiver's performance. Right. So if you look at this diagram, so this is the threshold that we can consider. This is the channel signal to noise ratio or carrier signal to noise ratio, and this is the signal to noise ratio at the output. If we exceed this limit, if the signal to noise ratio at the input of the receiver is greater than the signal to noise ratio at the output, then we will exceed this threshold. When we exceed this threshold, then we will not be able to reliably recover back our message signal, and we will encounter various types of noises called click noise at the output, and our output will not be reliable. It will have a lot of disturbances, right? And for computing the signal to noise ratio of the output of FM receiver, this is the equation that we have computed. And to avoid this threshold effect, we have to ensure that the carrier to noise ratio is greater than 1. If we violate this, then FM receiver breaks, in the sense that it will not be able to perform reliably, and it will introduce a lot of noises in the form of cracking noises and spotting noises, and thus our output will not be distortion free. It will have a lot of disturbances. Right, so to characterize the carrier's to noise ratio, this is the equation that we have computed, right? And the output signal to noise ratio at the output of the receiver may be measured initially in the absence of noise, and then in the absence of signal, right? So to measure how good is the receiver's performance, first we will measure the output signal at the output of the receiver in the absence of noise, and then we will measure the output of receiver in the absence of signal, right? And then we will take the ratio of the both, and we will say how good is the receiver's performance. Okay, so to have deeper insights into these concepts such as threshold effect and capture effect, we will solve some numericals, then you will have deeper insights into the concepts that I've discussed, be it capture effect or threshold effect. So let's move on to some numerical problems. So here we will be focusing on the FM receivers. So let me look at the figure of merit equation for FM receivers. This is the figure of merit equation for FM receiver. Figure of merit for AM receiver is FOM is equal to the signal to noise ratio at the output of the receiver divided by the signal to noise ratio at the input of the receiver, or signal to noise ratio of the communication channel C. This is equal to 1 by 2 Ka square AM square divided by 1 plus 1 by 2 Ka square AM square. That is equal to mu square by 2 plus mu square, where mu is the modulation index or modulation depth. Right. Now, let us compute a numerical problem. Please take out your calculators. I want you to tell me the answers for these numericals. So here they have given us the modulation depth in the case of AM modulation. They have given three modulation depth values. We are supposed to compute the figure of merit. So we know that the figure of merit is given by mu square by 2 plus mu A. In the first problem, we have mu is equal to 100%. If mu is equal to 100%, its value will be equal to 1. So if mu is equal to 1, tell me what is the figure of merit by using this equation. Tell me what is the figure of merit.
Sir? Sir, you're not audible, sir.
Hello, can you hear me now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. If there are any issues like that, please do unmute yourself and remind me. Thank you. So, this is the equation we have for figure of merit. So, figure of merit is equal to SNR O by SNR C. We are supposed to compute SNR C. Okay. And they have given us the value of modulation index, that is 0.8. So, how do you go about computing this? First step is use this formula of figure of merit, which is equal to 2 mu square, sorry, it's not 2, it is mu square by 2 plus mu square. Compute figure of merit. Once you compute figure of merit, use this formula of figure of merit that we have with in terms of SNRO and SNRC divided by SNRC. So compute figure of merit, and then SNRO, you can see the we have computed, that is absolute value is 1000. So you can put 1000 and you can compute SNRC. Okay, so before we come to this, please tell me what is the figure of merit you are going to get here. They have given us the modulation index as 0.8. So if mu is 0.8, tell me what is the figure of merit you are getting. All of you compute figure of merit. This is a very important problem. This has appeared many, many times in the VQ exam. So it is important for the exam as well as internals. Please compute and tell me the answer. What is the figure of merit you're going to get here? So Lavanya M has given me the answer. Very good. It is 0.2424. That is the figure of merit. Once you have figure of merit, put it here, 0.2424, and compute SNRC, which is the carrier to signal, carrier to noise ratio. Once you compute SNRC, take 10 log of this value and compute SNRC in terms of dB. Yes, can someone tell me what is SNRC? Good, Lavanya and Malashree has computed, have computed figure of merit. Okay, what about others? Substitute figure of merit here in this equation and tell me what is. SNRC is equal to 1000 divided by 0.2424. Tell me what is SNRC. Others are not responding. Why? Deeksha, Kalyani, Madhavaya, Manohar, Manoj, Munish, Nagaprasad, Pakirappa. Respond, tell me the answer. So SNR, C is 4125. Very good. And in dB, what is the SNR C value in decibels? Very good. Mukta, Lavanya, Kavita, Shreya, Rohan, Maas, Pooja, Sushmita have given me the answers. Kanchana, Kalyani, very good. Obubresru, Eldra, answer Martira. Okay. So what is the SNR C value? It is 30. 6.15. Okay, so this is the SNR C value. Okay, so you can see here, all of you please pay attention and listen to the values that we have got. You can see here the figure of merit. All of you please pay attention and listen carefully. The figure of merit that we have got here is a small value, that is 0.2424. Thus, if you look at the SNRC value, SNRC value is 36.15, but SNRO value they have given is 30 dB. Therefore, you can clearly see that the SNRC value is greater than SNRO value. So we will have significant amount of error or noise at the output, because the signal, the figure of merit is a smaller value. If we had a bigger figure of merit value, we would have had a greater SNRO value followed by SNRC value. Okay, so this is the correlation between a figure of merit and SNRC and SNRO values. Greater the figure of merit value, greater will be the SNRO value. Lesser the figure of merit value, greater will be the signal to noise ratio at the input of the receiver, or carrier to noise ratio will be a bigger value as compared to the signal to noise ratio at the output of the receiver. Okay. So, first thing is you have to compute the SNRO absolute value and then use this equation of figure of merit and compute SNR C absolute value and then SNRC in dB, that is 36.15. Very good. Many of you have given me the answer now. Okay, so that's it.